went viral in 2009. If you guys don't know what I'm talking about, search up Trololo. No lyrics, just la la la, Trololo. It became a huge meme. It was made fun of on every single social media platform you can think of. I recently looked up this song, and it actually has a much more rich history than I thought. First of all, there's competing stories as to how and why it was written without lyrics. One version, told by the guy that went viral in 2009, was that the author by the name of Arkady Ostrovsky tried to write about a cowboy going home to his wife, but it was a song about a cowboy, and it's a song about America, and he was Soviet. So the Soviet government said, no, you cannot put those lyrics in. Another version of how the lyrics were written said that the writer had an argument with his wife and then just never put the lyrics in. Just says, fuck it, I'm just going to put it like this. So we don't know exactly how the lyrics became tra-la-la, almost like a purposeful troll. But knowing it's Russian, maybe it was purposefully written like this, just to troll. I found four versions, not just the version that went viral in 2009, but I found four versions of this. So let's go through each version. The first version, of course, was the version that went viral. Millions, hundreds of millions of views, probably. But I remember I was just started college when it went viral. This is Eduard Khil's version from 1976. So Eduard Khil went viral, of course, and then he actually reprised it twice or three times that I know of. So let's watch his reprisals. So as I dig deeper, I find some interesting versions. I don't know if these were covers or these were actually the original, but one guy by the name of Muslim Magomayev, apparently he was the Frank Sinatra of Russia. He did his own version. So Muslim was from the Azerbaijan region of the Soviet Union. Now, this next singer, his name is Koz Janus. I'm really sorry if I said his name wrong. Koz Janus or Janus Koz. But he's a Romanian. So Romania was also part of the Soviet bloc. It wasn't a Soviet Union country, but it was part of the Soviet bloc, the Warsaw Pact. La 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 la, your golden mean fence. La 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 la, so close be mean then. The final version that I found was by a person named Valery Obozinski, also a Soviet singer.
La 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 la
I think what we can glean from this song, even though it reached troll potential in 2009, maybe it actually was kind of a troll potential type of song, even when it was first written. We don't know. I mean, I don't know much about the Soviet bloc. A lot of us don't really know. We might never know what was going on behind the Iron Curtain in the 70s, but it looked like the song was popular and it was covered by a lot of people. It wasn't just Mr. Eduard Khil, Mr. Trololo guy. It was a bunch of other famous singers singing it. It's kind of like when Friday, remember Rebecca Black's Friday? When that went viral, all these singers started covering it. So what do you guys think, man? Where were you when Trololo went viral on YouTube? I remember I wasn't aware. Someone sent me a site that just looped the song, and I thought my friend was sending me a virus, and I was like, what the fuck are you doing? She's like, oh, this is going viral on YouTube. Back then, I didn't even know about YouTube. Is that crazy? I was late to the game. Anyways, guys, thank you so much for watching. This was Jerry Sings. If you like this type of musical history type of exploration, let me know. Yeah.